Hey guys, today we're performing an oil change and we're going to discuss the oil filter size. Now, ever since I've owned the car and I did my first oil change, I always thought the oil filter was a bit on the small size. So today we're gonna be using K&N product as a reference point. The factory size is an HP-1008. And it's not that much bigger than like a motorcycle oil filter. And I've always find that kind of weird. Also comparing the casing, they're identical in diameter or outside diameter. You can even just verify by putting them together. And then if we look inside, they look identical. So the only test is we're just going to thread this on and see how it fits. Just for a quick comparison here for you guys, you can see that I have the both ends of the oil filters up against a straight edge. And then they both have their gaskets on them, so we can factor that in. So it's roughly about half an inch bigger. So it's not a much, much larger filter, but it makes sense, like why not put the bigger filter in, because we know it works across a other variety of vehicles. You get that much more capacity for longevity because you just have more material inside of it, so it can handle taking more debris out over a long period of time. And honestly, if we're thinking about the environment, it makes sense to standardize. Why are we producing so many different sizes of oil filters when for a Honda and a Nissan and across a wide range of environments, like a Pathfinder in theory will tow more than a GTR ever will or a 350, we could just standardize down to one size across a lot of vehicles on the market. So the only reason I thought, well, maybe the reason why they put a shorter filter on is because it's a clearance issue, but we can look at it. We have tons of clearance here. I'm only going to go half an inch, and you have to factor in, I also have an oil cooler. So I have the sandwich plate and I still have room. Those of you that don't have the sandwich plate, you're going to have even more room than I do. Okay, let's loosen off our old filter. We'll let that drain out. Now is also a good time for us to open up our valve to empty out our oil catch can. Okay, so I've primed my filter and I have oiled up the gasket. So let's just see how this new one threads on. Yeah, it's not the threads. Feel good, they're tight, threads on right away. And you have lots of clearance still. Okay, our drain plug's all tight. Our oil filter's all nice and tight, just have to put on our filter mag. So now we have to fill it up with oil and test it. So hopefully you guys can see here, you can see that double checking our fill line. So these dipsticks are really hard to read. So you see nothing's sticking onto there. So what we've done is here is we've actually taken really aggressive sandpaper, and then I've also used an automated center punch to give it some divots to help catch the oil and give us a more accurate reading. You can refer to my video on this and then look at the comments. A lot of people are really happy with this modification. And also for oil, we are still using 5W40 Castrol synthetic. It's been working really well for me. I'm very happy with oil pressure and how the car's just been working. And then we're also topping off with the AC Delco engine oil supplement. Okay, let's go ahead and fire up and just see how the oil pressure is. I don't expect to see any difference. That's pretty much where it ends up every time when I start the vehicle when it's cool. All right, let's lift it up and check for leaks. So just do your inspection, checking around the drain plug, looking really carefully around the filter. Now obviously we see some oil because we put oil on the gasket. What I'm looking for is here, if there's anything dripping down. So oil pressure's good, no leaks. And I think it's good practice to run the engine for a bit on these vehicles because you have that belly pan under here. So if you didn't tighten this enough or something's wrong over here, and you do your oil change, bun it all up, and there's like a little tiny leak, well, the belly pan's gonna collect all that, and it's not gonna drip to the floor, you're not gonna be aware of it. So running the engine, obviously in a safe manner, like we're on a lift, but you have it all secured, and you're not like directly underneath the vehicle, run it, and make sure you have no leaks, then you can go ahead and put everything back together. So yeah, this is looking good. Okay, laying the vehicle idle for a bit, holding revs at 2,500 once in a while. Kind of similar to what we do is when we were doing the bleed procedure for the cooling system, just to help it get up to operating temperature a little bit sooner. Looking at our oil pressure, it's looking good at idle. Bring up to 2,500. Bring up to 4. Yeah, everything's operating the exact same pretty much. Well, there you guys have it. Yes, you can put a bigger filter onto these cars. So please cross-reference, look up the HP-1010 from K&N, or you want to look up and cross-reference your 350Z or G35, look at Pathfinders of the same year, look at the GTR, and always, of course, double check the thread pitch. Compare the old filter to the new one, check the diameter, check the thread pitch, and then go ahead and do the installation. Once you've verified this part works in your vehicle, you can go ahead and keep on using it.